At nearly a metre long, the tuatara may look like a large lizard, but the resemblance is only skin deep. Tuatara are far more primitive. Their family tree split away from lizards more than 250 million years ago.
It would be easy to lump tuatara in with other reptiles like lizards, like geckos and skinks. But once you see one, it becomes very apparent that they are a completely different animal altogether.
The tuatara is the only survivor of an ancient group of reptiles known as rhynchocephalians, or beakheads. They're a sister group to the dinosaurs, but even more ancient and primitive. Yet the tuatara survived when most of its relatives couldn't. Their origins predate the dinosaurs by 20 million years. It's a history written into their strange anatomy. Tuatara have no openings for their ears and only limited hearing. But their large skulls do contain a remarkable third eye, complete with retina and nerve endings. Visible at birth, scales cover the eye within just a few months. Scientists are still uncertain of its purpose. But the third eye is just one of the tuatara's many surprises. Most modern animals have teeth that grow out of sockets. The tuatara's teeth grow direct from the jaw as one solid piece of bone, an adaptation perfect for life as a scavenger. The teeth work like scissors, allowing the tuatara to eat almost anything. When food is scarce, tuatara are capable of slowing their metabolism down, allowing them to survive for up to 12 months without eating. Their slow lifestyle helps them to live to more than 100 years old. Free of predatory mammals and offering plenty of food sources, Little Barrier Island is a vital refuge for a unique reptile threatened with extinction.
Guys, this is the juvenile part of the tuatarium. You go nice and quiet.
Okay, if you lift.
Here we go. Oh, he's a beautiful colour. Well, let's see what he is. He's a little dude. They do this amazing little crocodile roll where they're really, you see the strength in them. Sometimes when you pat them on their tummy, it calms them right down. Just relaxes them a little bit.
They're all muscle, really, aren't they?
Yeah, they are.
The team will monitor the growth of this young female. By the time she's fully grown, she will have more than tripled in size.
And then you see where the structure in the tail is a little bit different. There's where it lost tip of its tail and regrown.
The ability to shed their tail when attacked is an escape mechanism they share with lizards.
The whole idea is the tail keeps wriggling, and then whatever's going to eat the tuatara in this case will come in and go for the wriggling tail rather than the actual individual and gives them a chance to get away.
Tuatara were once plentiful throughout New Zealand, but their survival is now threatened. The arrival of humans and introduced predators nearly wiped them out. Their eggs were easy targets for introduced rodents.
The fossil records show that the moment rats arrived, tuatara disappeared.
Little Barrier is one of the few places where tuatara still survive in the wild. A breeding program was started in the 1990s when the island's tuatara population had fallen to just 8 adults. The threat of extinction was very real.
Tuatara have been here like over 200 million years, you know, and they could be gone like that if we didn't step in and do something for them.
Even today, their existence is fragile. But these animals survived when their larger, stronger competitors died out. How did Tuatara survive the catastrophic events that caused the dinosaurs to disappear? Clues are found in its survival strategies.
What have we got here?
One of the females here has laid some eggs under this paving stone. We'll dig them up because if we leave them here and the young ones hatch, there's a chance that the adults actually come in and eat them.
Cannibalism is a common survival strategy among reptiles. Great care is taken when removing the eggs from the burrow. Richard will transport them from here to an incubator.
They're quite fragile, these eggs.
They take a little bump, but of course, if I put any punches in them, there's a chance of damaging the eggs, so yeah, want to be as careful as we can.
These precious eggs developed in their mother's body for 8 months, a gestation period almost three times as long as most reptiles. The cool New Zealand climate forces the young to shelter in their egg for as long as 16 months. It's the longest incubation period observed in a reptile.
So I just write a little number on them for record, and also this way I know which way is up. They shouldn't be turned or moved too much.
Though Tuatara can lay up to 19 eggs at a time, it'll be at least 2 years before this female will be ready to lay again.
It really is like you're digging up treasure, isn't it?
Today, the team has recovered 10 eggs.
Pretty special,
wow.
Eh? To think this holding 200 million years of history in my hand. Incredible. I can't even describe how special that is.
Pop them in the vermiculite just down in here.
Gosh, no pressure.
Thanks to Little Barrier's breeding program, the original 8 Tuatara have multiplied. Over only a few years, the population has increased to nearly 300.
So that head start just gives them that little bit of extra push, I guess, you know, like a bit of safety net.